Well, welcome everybody and welcome council. I'd like to call this council meeting to order, please. And we'll start as always with a moment of silent reflection, please. Thank you very much. I'd also like to take this time to acknowledge that this meeting is being held on the traditional territory of the Mississauga Nation. And I also ask council to disclose any pecuniary interest, the nature thereof, direct or indirect, or any conflict. And we have not received any written ones, and I can see everybody and I don't see any response to that. So we'll proceed. I'd like next to ask our fire chief if he could bring us up to date and have a discussion about COVID. And I also want to just take the time, Dan, to thank you for all the work you're doing. We do see a lot of, you know, input, and it's taking a lot of time. So things are on the upswing, hopefully. But, you know, on behalf of council and all the residents, thank you.
Thank you, Mayor Sanderson. So this evening for our COVID-19 update for the municipality, I'm happy to report that today there are zero cases reported new for Northumberland County. There are presently 17 unresolved cases throughout Northumberland County, 27 unresolved cases within our health unit. We still remain at 15 total hospitalizations and 11 deaths, and those two numbers haven't changed in quite some time. And there's presently one local outbreak still continuing. The variant has shown up within our municipality. Thankfully, it has been contained to one household thus far. Aside from the COVID counts, I can also touch on vaccinations. So vaccinations are underway for hospital staff at Northumberland Hills. And we're presently in the process now of scheduling our first responders for vaccinations. And that does include our local Port Hope Police Service, as well as our firefighters within our three stations in Port Hope, with hope that their vaccinations take place between Thursday and Friday of this week. Additionally, on top of that, the next plans for provincial rollout are vaccinations for those individuals over the age of 80, so 80 plus. And we'll be working closely with the health unit in the coming days and weeks in order to figure out how that rollout will take place, locations, timings, and things of that nature. That is the COVID update for this evening, unless anyone has any questions.
Well, it'll open up for any questions, and I'm really glad to hear the progress that that we're making with the health unit. Any questions? So then I'm anticipating the over 80s. There's discussion that it'll be through appointments and either physicians and what have you. Is that still online?
That is what we suspect. Again, we'll have more clarification hopefully on Friday.
Okay. I certainly hope that's the situation. It seems to be working in other jurisdictions. And I think it, you know, stops the requirement for the elderly to move around too much if they don't feel comfortable with it. And I also think it is nice when somebody can deal with their own position as well. So anyway, excellent news, nice update, and thank you very much. I'm now gonna ask Councillor Bickle, do you have a safety update for us today?
Just like to remind everybody that winter isn't basically over yet. So just in case we happen to do get another heavy snowfall, to not to forget to clean out around the fire hydrants on your property if you have one in front of your house. And our volunteer firefighters run a green light in their vehicles when they're responding to the halls for a call. So if you happen to see a green light coming up behind you, have the courtesy to pull over a little bit to the side of the road to let them by. It doesn't give them the right to speed, but they could be responding to a friend, a neighbor, or even worse, somebody of your own household. So you just never know where they're going and what kind of a call they're on. So just show a little respect to those green lights and give them the opportunity to get by if you can. That's all I have to say.
Well, I appreciate that, Councillor Bickle. From a community update perspective, just a couple of things I'd like to comment on. We recently went through the coldest night of the year. I think everybody may have got their cap. We did achieve our goal. I think our goal was $375, and we achieved $1,750. So I'd like to thank everybody who participated and who donated as well. And it was a true good council endeavor to a great cause. Also, just a reminder as well, our next council is not till the 16th, but daylight saving comes in on March the 14th. So I thought that would be something to put out there everybody can look forward to. We have a couple of days not to miss your meetings, but it coming soon. I actually looked that up because I was kind of waiting, you know, the days as well. So your daffodils might be okay, Councillor Bickle. And I kind of hope that people have had a chance to walk through Memorial Park and to admire some of the work that has been there. It's the Ice Sculpture Gallery, and it's brought to you by Critical Mass. That's a center for contemporary art that's been very active and positive in the community. So the Gallery of Sculptures is impressive, and I commend Critical Mass for the unique and COVID-friendly initiative. They seem to be able to come up with some very good, you know, opportunities for the municipality to have a look at what they bring forward. And Big Brothers and Big Sisters will be launching their online initiative for the 2021 Move for Kids' Sake fundraiser. Although it goes on between February 16th and April the 16th, then I think it actually should be probably March 16th or April 16th. That might be a typo here. Big Brothers and Big Sisters of Northumberland in this community's leading child and youth mentoring organization. And they've been serving Northumberland County child and youth mentoring for them to serve the community in the community for many, many years. And they totally rely on community fundraising. So I encourage you to visit their website for more information. And that's at Northumberland Big Brothers, Big Sisters, and it's.ca. And with that, we'll move on the agenda unless anybody on council would like to bring up another community good news story. So I'm going to move on to our consent agenda. We have 2, 3.1, and 3.2. If anybody on council would like to draw either one of those out for separate discussions, I'll do so. I don't see any indication. So 3.1 is the council meeting minutes of February 16th, 2021. 3.2, committee of the whole meeting minutes of February 16th, 2021. Could I have a move and a seconder to receive these as circulated, please? Moved by Councillor Carr, seconded by Councillor Lees. All those in favor? Thank you. Seeing none opposed, that's unanimous and carried. Any business from the previous minutes or notification of new business from Council? Seeing none, we'll go to item 5 on our agenda, which is petitions and delegations. And tonight, we do not have any. And item 6 is correspondence. We do not have any to discuss as well. And on 7, we do not also have any staff or committee reports, which moves us into item 8 on our agenda, which is the consent agenda for resolutions. There's 8.1, 8.2, and 8.3. And again, does any councillor wish to draw any of these out for separate discussion? I don't see any indication, and I can see everybody. So 8.1. 10-2020 recommendation from Finance Committee, February 16, 2021, the 2021 insurance renewal. 8.2 is 11-2021 recommendation from Parks, Recreation, and Culture Committee, which is February 16, 2021, and that's the Civic Awards Program Policy. 8.3 is 12-2021 recommendation from Parks, Recreation, and Culture Committee, February 16, 2021, Danny Weekend Campaign Report. Have a move and a seconder to receive these, please. Moved by Councillor Meadows, seconded by Councillor Bickle. Any last minute discussion on any of those? I'll call the vote. All those in favor? Thank you. That is unanimous, so it's carried. I'm going to move to bylaws. Just let me grab them here. Rona bylaws, item 9 on your agenda. I need a mover and a seconder. Now, therefore, be it resolved that bylaw 12-2021, being a bylaw to authorize execution of a site plan agreement between Explornet Communications, Inc., the tenant, Yvonne and Peter Vandervint, the owners, and the Corporation of the Municipality of Port Hope for lands municipally known as 5316 County Road 28, be read a first and second time. Could I have a mover, please? Moved by Councillor Lees, second by Councillor Mink. Is there any discussion on that? I'm going to call the vote. All those in favor? Thank you. Again, all hands were up, so that's unanimous and carried. Now, therefore, be resolved that bylaw 12-2021 be read a third time, passed, and that said bylaw be signed by the mayor and the clerk, sealed with the seal of the corporation, and engrossed in the bylaw book. Could I have a mover, please? Councillor Meadows and the Deputy Mayor Andrews, all those in favor? Thank you again. Unanimous and carried. Item 10 on the agenda is new and other business. Do we have any from council? I don't see any, so I'm going to move on to the county update. And again, I just have a couple of items here. To enhance the safety of visitors to the Northumberland County Forest, gates have been installed at all 5 trailheads, and it was done in January of 2021. Funded using provincial safe restart dollars, these gates are intended for use by Forest Service in the event of any sort of an emergency. They will remain open at all other times. When closed, these gates signal unsafe conditions in the forest, such as trail damage due to significant weather events, active timber harvest operations, a fire, or declared emergency. If visitors to the forest notice that the gates to a trail are closed, for their own safety, they are asked to please visit an alternative trailhead that day. The county makes every effort to notify the public of trail closures on its website and via social media. And for more information about visitor safety in the county forest, visit northumberland.ca and then /safety. Forest safe forest visits. Also effective now, March 1, garbage bag tags increased to $4.25 per tag. That's an increase of 50 cents from $3.75, and this increase relates to the increased cost of waste management services for the community. At the end of 2019, the county launched enhanced waste management programs with a new curbside collection contract coming into effect at that time. In addition to long-standing garbage, recycling and leaf and yard waste collection, this expanded contract addresses new waste programs such as the green bin, that's food waste collection, and the two-stream recycling, including the new equipment required to deliver these programs. The purpose of these programs is to extend the life of the Brighton landfill, that's the only community last landfill, by an additional 4 to 5 years until the year 2034-35. And this was a long debate by County Council, with the outcome being a positive to support this, because in the end, it does support our recycling, and it also, in effect, becomes a user fee. If the increases required for garbage pickup went on the levy, it's, as we all know, it would be compounded year after year. So I think this is a move that, you know, sometimes we'll get some pushback, I think, from the public. I've sent you all, you know, comprehensive information so that you should be able to answer any questions the public has regarding this. And also free stopping the COVID-19 endemic online learning session. Help stop the spread of misinformation during COVID-19, and you can learn how to identify and share credible sources of information. And you can register for their free stopping the COVID-19 infodemic session, and it's available at various dates and times until March 19th, and you can also learn more at the northumberland.ca, then again /digital literacy. And our next county council meeting is March 17th of this year, of course. I think with that, I'm going to open it up to question period. I'm going to start with questions from council. Are there any questions that council would like, or any council would like to bring forward? Seeing none, I'm going to move on to the public and to the news media and the press. All the information required to participate in our meetings has been well documented and presented to the public on all our websites. So if there is anybody out there who has a question, please bring it forward and I'll ask our clerk to just advise council.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. As you just noted, now would be the time for anyone listening in to indicate that you have a question. So we'll leave that open for a few seconds here. At this moment in time, I don't see anything, but let's just leave it and see if anything comes up. Mr. Mayor, there is no indication of any questions from those listening in.
Okay, thank you very much. Then I'll ask for a motion for adjournment and we'll move into committee of the whole in just a couple of minutes. We've been fairly quick on this meeting, so I don't think we need a long break. Could I have a mover please to adjourn? Councilor Bickle? Seconder? Councilor Mink? All those in favor? Thank you. So we can stay on this site and I'll start that meeting in probably about 2 minutes.